What's up, guys? Jacob Ober here. Welcome to another episode of BuckTalk, and today we're going to be discussing Milwaukee's Christmas Day victory over the New York Knicks, a 109-95 decision at Madison Square Garden. So first of all, I hope you guys are all having a fantastic Christmas Day. Really happy that the Bucks were able to get to play on Christmas for the first time in 41 years. It's been a really long time, obviously, but I'm really glad that I got to see the Bucks finally play on Christmas Day. That's always been, since I started watching the Bucks, it's always been like one of the things I wanted to see the most, to see this team play on Christmas Day. And even though they got the bad matchup of the day, the 11 o'clock game against the crappy team, the Knicks, it was still really entertaining to watch. I mean, Giannis had 30 points, a few highlight reel dunks, a highlight reel block, and of course Mario Hezonja, the guy who dunked on him just about a month ago, did not play a single minute in this game, so there was no opportunity for Giannis to dunk on Hezonja. They will be playing the Knicks, I think, 2 days from now, on the 27th, on Thursday, so maybe he'll get an opportunity then. But today, though, the Bucks, they took care of business. They did not play their best game of the season, especially from behind the arc. They only shot 19%, 6 of 32. Definitely one of their worst shooting days from behind the arc today. I think there was a point in the game where they had missed 17 straight threes, but that didn't matter because the Bucks were dominant enough. They had a lot of good ball movement. They set themselves and their teammates up well. They didn't turn the ball over very much. And the Knicks, they were able to hang with the Bucks for about 2.5 quarters or so. About midway through the third is when the Bucks started taking control of the game, and that's what the better team does. I mean, the Knicks, they're not good. They're a scrappy team that can sometimes give you a little bit of a fight, and they certainly did when they beat the Bucks about a month ago. I think that was December 5th, actually. I thought it was 20 days to the day, but the Knicks, they tried to hang with the Bucks for a little bit, but unfortunately they just don't have enough talent to be able to hang with them the entire game. As for Giannis, he was matched up with Noah Vonleh. I actually thought Noah Vonleh played some pretty good defense on Giannis, but Giannis was hitting his jump shots today, and he got set up for some easy baskets, and he ended up finishing with 30 points on 13 of 21 shooting. Set the Bucks' Christmas Day record for rebounds with 14, passing Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. It was a really good game for him. As for Chris Middleton, however, the supposed second fiddle to Giannis, once again, he's continuing his slump, and it's starting to get a little bit concerning at this point. He was 2 for 12 today with 6 points, 1 for 7 from behind the arc. 4 of those 6 came on one play where he hit a 3 and got fouled and hit the free throw for a 4-point play. But, I don't know what's going on with Chris Middleton right now, but I remember when the season started, everyone was like, man, Chris Middleton, he's playing such good basketball right now, and he was. But right now, it's like, he doesn't look like a max player to me. He doesn't look like a guy who, like, if I had to choose right now, at this very moment in time, between Bledsoe, Middleton, and Brogdon, I would choose Bledsoe and Brogdon over Chris Middleton. Now, there obviously that can change as the season goes on, and I really hope Chris Middleton breaks the slump, but the fact is that he seems to have these slumps every single year. He's not a consistent enough player for me, and that's why I'm a little concerned about this. Like, I was hoping this was the year where he played consistently like a 25 and 5 guy the entire season, but right now he's playing like he can't even score more than 15 points in a game. I mean, he's had some good games in some spots during the slump. I believe he scored 25 against the Pistons a week ago or so, but he's had some good games in this little slump he's had, but overall he's just been really poor shooting. I don't think he's shot over 50% in a game since November. It's just getting kind of out of hand at this point. Hopefully he's able to rebound and get out of this slump and get back to the Chris Middleton we remember him to be, but right now he doesn't look like that second star that we were hoping he would be behind alongside Giannis. Right now, that's looking a lot more like Eric Bledsoe, who also didn't really have the best game today. But, I mean, he was still able to scrap together like 10 points or so, and he was still a pretty positive contributor. And he also plays some really good defense. So, Eric Bledsoe might very well be an all-star this year. He might be the all-star over Chris Middleton if the Bucks are to get a second all-star besides Giannis. But overall, though, it was a pretty good game. The bench, outside of Maker, really wasn't that special. Tony Snell, Sterling Brown did not play very well. Thon Maker, though, Thon Maker had a really good game. I think he finished with 12 points. He was in the paint for a lot of the game, actually. I think he was posting guys up and hitting turnaround hook shots and stuff. Like, he looked pretty good for the most part. He looked a little bit awkward at times, you know, like he usually does. But for the most part, he was pretty good after a really poor start to the game. But overall, this was a good victory. Really glad to see the Bucks get the victory on Christmas. Like I said, I've wanted to see the Bucks play on Christmas ever since I became a Bucks fan. And today, that dream became something that actually happened. So, anyways, guys, so thanks for watching. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Did you enjoy watching the Bucks on Christmas? And do you hope they play on Christmas next year as well? Be sure to leave a like and subscribe. And as always, go Bucks. We'll see you guys next time.